Hey guys, how's it going? Back with another video today. Today you can actually see that I have a bit more energy and there's a very good reason for that and I'm going to share that with you in just a wee second. And before I do, I just want to say I am over the moon. I am very happy with where I'm sitting at the moment in regards to my weight, and as well as that, I have now finished my depletion workouts and I have now finished cardio altogether. So that's put me in a good mood. But the main reason why I am so happy this morning is today is the carb up. And I don't know how long I've been saying for, but when this carb up is going to happen, there's going to be one place I'm going and there's going to be a couple of things I'm going to get. So if you're excited to see what I'm about to get, please be sure to share and subscribe and sit back, relax and enjoy this video because it's going to be a good one today. So currently in Lidl, and there's one place I'm going, so the bread area. Let's see what we get. So we're going to do some damage today. Unfortunately, the only two pastries is such I can touch the stuff up here. These other ones, which are pan au chocolat and croissants, are going to have to be kept until Sunday, but that's all right because I still have a lot of food in the house today that I'm going to be eating. I'm going to be trying some new cereal today for the first time and a few other things like that, so I can't wait to try it out and show you. Now, I wouldn't even call this the icing on top, but it is a very good start to the day. There are things that I'm going to be buying today. Now, I just want to make clear as well that I won't be able to eat. Obviously, we're still on a diet and we still have to stick to certain protocols set by Peter. So the main goal today is to eat about 300 grams of carbs or so and just to see how I'm going after each meal. And if I'm doing okay, then we might get a carb up tomorrow. And yeah, that's really it for now. I don't want to speak too much about my water loading or anything like that because I would have to say it's been pretty unhealthy and I don't want to promote that, but I will speak about it in a later video and just when I'm rounding up everything that happened on my diet and things I might not have shown and just wee things like that, because I think it'd be good just to be transparent with yous and just let you really know how I got on, because obviously I've shown you only a certain amount of hours of my diet and not the whole thing. As you know, I've been doing this for the last 18 weeks, 24 hours, going to bed, waking up with it. But you haven't seen all that. You've only seen maybe one or two videos a week when I've been picking up the camera. I'll be looking to do that then at the end of the day. But for now, back to the house for the first meal. And I cannot wait to have some carbs for the first time in basically a week. Just look at the freshness of this bread. Oh, I cannot wait to get this in me. I'm just so excited. I'm like near enough shaking.
So now it's the time I've been waiting for, the first bite.
I can't believe it. So 18 weeks, very minimal carbs. Now being able to eat some again, which is absolutely phenomenal. My reaction today is going to be like this all day compared to the last video where I was down in the dumps, ready to call it quits. It was so hard, but a wee bit of jam and a bit of bread. Oh, it just makes everything so much better. Now, this is something more that I would definitely call a breakfast. So, a few things here. So I've got my standard omelette and I've got bagels again and I've got some chocolate hazelnut spread from My Protein. Stuff I use is this stuff here. The macros are really good on it. Per serving, you're getting roughly around 5 carbs, 5 fat, and 3 protein. So I can't be complaining for some chocolate spread that tastes exactly like Nutella. And then in my bowl here, I have the Seriously Cinnamon, or some people call it Cinnamon Toast Crunch. And I have 300 mils of milk as well with that.
So I'm going to eat all this now and then have a few clients and then we'll be on the road to Dublin. I'm not too sure what other food I'll be having as well before that.
Now, since I haven't had carbs in a while, I think it'd be rude not to show or share my first bite with near enough every single carbohydrate that I have today, because it's absolutely heaven. So trying it now with the chocolate spread. Just absolutely amazing. Probably can even see, just I feel better already just eating carbs again. It's so good. Oh my God, I don't even know what prep when I finish that, what it's gonna be like.
So finally arrived in Dublin and just a quickly snack just to keep me going until I get back up the road, because down here do a good bit of shopping for the end of the week. But because I'm down here and I don't have any food with me, I'm just getting some clean carbs, not the cleanest, but it'll do for now, especially is with the size of the shortbread. So I'm having some of that now, but it's gonna be a good day with the amount of stuff I'm gonna be buying.
So the hardest part of today is actually gonna be making sure that I don't eat the food that I buy, for instance, that I'm allowed in a few days. So for instance, I've got some of the Fox's chocolate chip cookies here. I know they're absolutely amazing from eating them in the past, but it's now making sure that I don't eat them today because we're still on a diet. So that's the main thing that we have to remember. So wish me luck that I don't cave in, and my willpower that I've built up over the last 5 months has definitely been worth it. So the main reason why I'm here is for one reason only. If you watched my Liverpool vlog, you would know why. But just in case you're not sure, that's the reason why we're here today. So last time I only got 3 donuts, which were from my mum. This time they're all for me. So we don't do things half-hearted here. We don't go in for 3 donuts. No. We did much better. Going for 24 donuts. So I'll take you through the process in here. And then yeah, we're getting 24 donuts. I cannot wait. I tried so hard and got so far. Doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. I tried so hard and got so far. And here's just some of the donuts that I got then. I thought I'd try out some special ones, such as the Xbox ones, as you can see on the right there. Then we've got some Nutella ones and some like chocolate brownie ones. And then in the other pack, we've got just the standard original donuts along with some other ones as well. Now I've just finished my shop in Aldi altogether, and I'm not even gonna joke. For the 3 bags here, it ended up being about €70 altogether. And for the amount of stuff that we've got, it's absolutely phenomenal. Like, where do you see the receipt here? Let me see. Sorry, £65.92 for that whole list of things there. You know, I've got turkey mince, got some bread, you know, some snacks as well with potato, and more turkey burgers, plenty of stuff, but yeah. So I'll break everything down that I got when I get home then for you as well, but absolutely phenomenal the amount of stuff that you can get from Aldi, just knowing that we don't have them back up at home anyway. So home now, and as you can see, I'm just watching the donuts there, don't worry. I'm not gonna eat them. I definitely have the willpower, so I'll give you one final look at the donuts now. Everything we got, 24 of them. I'm just gonna close these up and just leave them on the table for the next day and a half, and then I can go all out at them. And yep, just gonna leave them there. Anyway, from all the food that I got today, I'm not gonna show you as much of it, and if I show you any of it, and that's because this is gonna be for after my dad. This isn't food that's going to be on my diet, and obviously I'm still showing you the series of me getting shredded. So I'm only going to be showing you food that I am eating still to get shredded. So a bit of a crazy fact, which I'm sure a lot of you don't know, is that when you get a spray tan, it can really stain your nails and it can leave it for actually a couple of months. And obviously I'm not looking to have stained nails and be walking about and everything like that. So I was asking around on things and what I can do to make sure that they don't get stained, and there was only one option, and as a result I've done it. So let me show you what I've had to do. This here is clear nail varnish, and unfortunately it is now on my fingernails, and that is because I don't want my nails getting stained. So I've now had to put that on tonight, which is great. The next step now is to put on the tan,
which is the fake tan, which is a base layer. So that'll be going on tonight, which is going to be fun. These are the things that you have to do to get into the final stages. You just have to do some things that are a bit unnatural. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. It's something different. And of course, it won't be done again, hopefully. But yeah, this is the next step now. It does feel weird though, I have to say. My fingernails feel like, well, of course there's something on them, but it feels like there's something really heavy on them. And I know it's not the case, but yeah, that's how they feel right at the moment. So I'll just show you a wee quick physique update. So in the light here, just stand flat and tense.
It hasn't been such a long time since people first started shopping online, and it was easy to keep up with the clicks. Little by little by little by more, the clicks added up to be more than the stores, and e-tailers worked harder than ever before because they had to keep up with the clicks. No time for borders.
So yeah, that's where I'm at the moment. Still have one more day to go tomorrow, so tomorrow is one day out. And I'm looking forward to it, and I cannot wait to see the results then. Alright guys, so we are now less than 24 hours out. I'm just going to end today's video here, and I just want to say it is so close now, and I cannot wait. There's just a few last touches that I need to do. So I'm just going to have to end today's video here to start tomorrow's video. I can't wait for it, and I'm hoping that you're looking forward to it as well. The big news and the most important thing is we got the green light. So basically the green light is when you're coming up to your end of your photo shoot prep and things like that. Your PT will give you the green light whether or not it's good to go ahead tomorrow. And that's just the news I wanted to hear today, because sometimes what can happen is if you spill over on your dad, they might push it back a few days or things like that there. And that's not the case for me, so ready to go tomorrow. Cannot wait to finally finish this dad after 18 and a half weeks. It's going to be so good, and I cannot wait for it. So anyway guys, I just want to say thanks for watching. Please be sure to share and subscribe, and until next time, goodbye.